Maar goed dat jij het even inleidt, Jesse, ja?
Hij staat aan, jongens. Echt waar.
Nice.
Ja.
So moet ik even checken. To English.
We have to switch to English.
Oh, dat nog.
Indeed.
Hey, is it possible that you go a little bit like that? Because otherwise we'll constantly be like this, right?
A bit in front.
Switching,
a little bit like that. Is that possible?
Waarschijnlijk ga je naar voren op verzoek.
So we have visuals.
All right. Yeah. We have visuals and we're live. Let's check if all the audio works.
Which camera do we have to look at?
Better?
Dit is de commercial some reason.
Dit is hem.
Ja. Oké. We're live, guys.
COVID screen.
Okay.
That camera is on, so I'm out of focus, but Mark Otte is in focus. I'll first introduce you.
Sharp as ever.
Yeah, I can't get them all sharp, but the system is sharp, so that's okay. On your right, for the viewers, we have Rinus, and he is one of the mastering engineers for Artone Record Industry. And this is, by the way, the Artone Studio.
Mm-hmm. Welcome.
So thank you very, very much that we can use this fabulous room.
Okay.
You guys will all hear how great this room is, actually. Next to Rinus is Mark Otte. We interviewed him before.
Yep.
And he is in the, can I say the dance music?
Yeah, absolutely.
So he has some great ears and he's helping us out.
And great,
just like Rinus.
And great beats. You brought some great beats.
Just like Rinus, because his work is actually mastering and mixing, and Mark creates music and he helps out students.
Yep.
Well, next to Mark is the famous Yung Lee. This is our 13th live stream together.
Wow.
So this is
Sunday the 13th.
Yeah. Well, the famous 13.
Yes.
next to Jung is a decibel meter. So you know that
me decibel.
We all level the speakers to 74 dB.
And next to me is Jaap.
Well, yeah.
head honcho of Alpha Audio.
Yeah.
How many years did you found Alpha Audio?
It's 10 years ago now it's getting serious. Yeah.
Started as a hobby in the spare bedroom at his home, and now we're here in this beautiful music. Well, what is it? Hub
studio.
Yeah, it's a studio. Well, but we're you know we're
like this. Yeah, the situation. Yeah,
three rooms apart, and then there's record industry, of course, the record manufacturing, record factory,
pressing plant,
pressing plant. Yeah.
And then there's music on vinyl, so there's so much, and there are producers there, and there's us.
In this building.
Discogs used to work here.
Yeah.
Special used to rehearse.
And a printing house, so it's a non-stop production house.
Yeah.
I saw some sleeves of records.
Yeah, let's do a quick shout out to Tom. Vermeulen.
Yeah, owner of all this. So that's
the owners.
Yeah. Mieke as well, of course.
And behind the scenes, let's not forget Martijn. You can't see him, but he's doing all the audio. Yeah. Thank you, Martijn, for doing all the work behind the scenes. I hope the stream will be fluent, because I think YouTube is having some issues with frame drops. Oh. But know that if the audio will be okay, and this stream will stay available online, and we're recording it right now, so everything will be fine. Let's introduce all the speakers. We have the Dutch&Dutch in front of us now. Let's see that one. I'm switching the camera to the system. That's the Dutch&Dutch 8C. And we're starting out with this one because it's the cheapest one. And there is a consumer version and there is a pro version. This is the consumer version. So it's finished a little bit more neat,
but sonically it's
sonically
the
they're exactly the same. Around 10,000 euros. It is straight from 35 hertz to 20 kilohertz, and below 35 it's going down a little bit. There's an 8-inch woofer in the front but also in the back, so it's dual. It's and a DSP inside the speaker corrects all the phase stuff and response. The woofer has 500 watts, mid-range and tweeter have 250 watts. So it's 1,000 watts per speaker.
Jesus.
That wow. should do. and what strikes me is that you can actually control it with a network. So it's completely network connected. You can do everything in the network. It has an own interface. You can measure the room. You can correct stuff. And this is all set up by Dutch&Dutch themselves. So it should work out just fine.
It's from Belgium.
No, it's Dutch. Sucker.
Yeah, come on.
Well, I'm not that sharp, dude.
You never heard of it?
I
never
got up at brand, 7. No. I'm
you
tired.
Never heard of it?
No, I've never heard of the brand. No.
Well, it's there are three pairs of speakers in this room, and two of them are Dutch. That's quite funny.
Yeah. Who is behind Dutch&Dutch?
Martijn Mensink is one of the guys that I mainly speak with. But they're around for I don't know how many years. I think 6 or something.
Yeah, not that long.
No, not that long, but not that short either.
By the way, they're side ported, right?
Yeah, they are.
Yeah.
And there's one thing I want to say beforehand, and then we're gonna play some music. So don't freak out. We're actually gonna play music. We asked a lot of producers to send in their stuff. It's a tough market to get samples. We asked PMC. They didn't want to play in this room. It's a live room, but you can see it's actually acoustically treated very well. And we measured the room Friday. And, well, the response is very, very good.
Yeah, not bad.
It's not bad at all.
No.
It's a lot better than our listening room. Yeah. Especially in the low frequencies and left and
Pina
right.
Acoustics.
What?
Yeah. Shout out to Pina Acoustics.
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. Yeah. It's really yeah. good.
Amazing.
And what strikes me is that left and right is exactly the same. So yeah. left speaker is exactly the same as the right speaker.
Is it the first time you do audio equipment in this room instead of
We all have some feedback system for artists and musicians. Yeah. But this is a serious tryout, and we are happy with it.
There was a reader who was talking about that. It was he was having his doubts on this test. He said, "Well, it's a live room and not a studio, not a control room." But I think this is this is the it's almost the perfect living room in acoustics. It's not too dry because that one is pretty dry.
Yeah.
In my
it's not dry at all. It's
and yet it's well controlled. So you don't have the.
Well, you can hear it in your voice.
It's
very natural. Yeah. So, but we asked PMC. That was one. Key didn't have a sample. They had 40 speakers in back order, so they just didn't have anything. Focal. The distributor in the Netherlands said, "Yeah, I don't know about Focal in this test because they're not really in this category." And PSI, they did want to send in, but there's going to be a new version of the speaker that was in this test, planned in this test. So they said, you can test it, but in a month, it has a completely different mid-range.
Mm-hmm.
So that's not very...
Problem.
Yeah, so that's
the big one.
Yeah, the big one. Yeah, it's going to be changed. So that was, I think, about the setup. So we have three beautiful speakers. And let's start out with the first one.
Okay.
If any of you guys have a track you want to hear, just send it in with the chat. I'm going to follow the chat. And if it's a great track, we'll try it in the stream. So, first track. Let's try...
Sunday
morning. Before I forget, the source is a DCS Rossini with clock, and it was provided by More Music, so we're very happy with you. Yeah, thank you for sending it in. It's not the cheapest.
What's the price tag?
I have no clue. I think it's more than my car. A lot more than my car.
People don't know what your car could be.
I guess it's around 30,000 euros.
Yeah, together with the clock?
Something like that, maybe more. The clock is really expensive. I know. That's
beautiful.
But it's a DCS Rossini with the clock. You guys probably know better what it costs. And it's a lovely source. By the way, we tested 2 days ago. And Wait. And now it sounds better after 2 days. So it needs a warm-up time.
Yeah.
It's quite long, actually. It's we're going to start out with our favorite track, Jacques Louché, Little Fugues in G minor. That's not bad.
Well, if it would have been bad with this setup, that would have been a problem.
That would have been a problem.
This is the cheapest system.
This is the cheapest of the three. Yeah.
It's very good.
What do you think of their recording?
Good. Yeah, I think it's a good recording also. Of course, that's the basis of
Telarc recording on made in very close miking.
Mm. Yeah, that you hear, yeah. What I like.
It's really close.
The floor tom is insanely...
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's the coolest thing in the whole track.
Kaboom, kaboom. Yeah. Yeah.
Well, it's really hard on most speakers, I notice, because Jung and I use this track all the time. Mm-hmm. It's one of our reference tracks, and the floor trom is the part that most speakers have trouble with.
It's the same ball.
It's really hard. Let's get to the second one. I'm really curious. Let's play Vultures by John Mayer. It's one of your favorite tracks, Mark.
It's the track I basically always put on first listen.
The pricing, by the way, this speaker system is 10,000 euros a pair. The ATCs are around 15. And the Grimm Audios are 36. So there is a major difference in pricing, but I'm amazed by this smallest system already.
And they all look so differently.
Completely different.
So
these ATCs are.
So the family as a whole can also discuss whether it looks right in the
room.
Yeah,
definitely. Yeah, they're really different. Let's get to John Mayer.
Jongens, ik dacht dat Martijn erbij zou zitten eigenlijk.
Ja, dat was ook het idee, maar toen ging Martijn zeggen dat hij de audio moest doen. Want ik kan hier niet alles schakelen.
Nee, precies.
Dat is niet te doen. Ja? Stream staat aan. Nou, dan...
Ik denk dat we het een beetje zo moeten doen of zo.
Ja, dat denk ik wel.
Het is
wel
goed dat jij het even
inleidt
eerst, ja.
Hij staat aan, jongens. Echt waar.
Nice.
Ja.
So we switch to English.
We have to switch to English.
Oh, dat nog.
Indeed.
Hey, is it possible that you go a little bit like that? Because otherwise we'll...
Do they want from me all of these vultures hiding right outside my door?
It's a very nice track, Mark. I actually didn't hear it from the complete track. Never.
You did? Oh, wow.
No, it's well done.
Yeah, amazing.
There are two things in the chat, and I was just called by Martijn. There was an issue with Pro Tools. It's fixed now.
Oh.
Sorry about that. And there's a thing about the windows.
Oh.
They are not actual windows.
No.
It's an optical illusion. So they're actually LED panels.
It's LED, yeah.
So no worries about losing bass through glass. I have that issue in my listening room, and I actually treated it, and it took a lot of time to get it fixed. So yes, you are right. If it were Windows, we would have an issue with bass, but they're not actual Windows. So what do you think, Mark?
Well, I thought I knew this track in and out.
Yeah.
But yet I heard new things. So that's...
What did you hear?
In chorus 2, there is an extra layer underneath the vocals. I'm not completely sure what it is. There's quite a lot of Wurlitzer in there. It could be just a layer of Wurlitzer that I never really discerned, that I never really heard before like that. What struck me is that how much detail of the backgrounds of the layers came through, maybe more than I've ever heard. And I've heard this on some amazing systems. So,
but the recording is not perfect, you know. You hear the Fs and the S are
exactly. Yes. But that's one of the reasons why I like to hear it, because I work in studios, of course, and I like my systems to be honest. And that's actually something, this sounded a little bit more timid, a little bit more mellow than I'm used to with this track. Normally the vocal is even more like in your face, a little bit aggressive. Actually, I think I know what compressor they used on the vocal that makes that, because that's normally the URI 1176.
Possible.
Yeah.
That's only what I heard also with a bit of track before in this. There is something in the mid-range which is a bit more than normal. I know this voice on this track. I know the track also.
Yeah. Yeah.
It's aggressive of the S's and the
case.
I'm like a cutting engineer, so I always... Oh dear, yes. My de-esser,
This is where you...
I listen on that way also. Where's the de-esser? Because we have to put it down.
Yeah.
But I have the impression that it's a bit more than on the original.
Okay.
The mid-range for the S's and the K's, but you know, maybe better than...
Well, that could very well be. Yeah. What I hear is that in an area below the S's and T's, I am used to a little bit more, which is weird. Okay, I didn't know the first track. I've never heard that. But I did hear resonances in the piano.
Yeah.
Is that the recording?
Yeah.
Ah, okay.
And it's funny that you say it's mellow, because Phil is one of our one of the viewers we have in the streams very often, and he says it's very honest, but you can listen to it for hours. And I think he's absolutely right.
Yep.
It's a very honest speaker, but it's still laid back.
And it has some energy as well.
So the bass is lovely.
Yeah, what you have with the toms in the first track, I have with the snare in this track.
Okay.
And it could have a little bit more punch.
Okay. Yeah.
There are a few. So that's what I mean when I say timid. It's, I think. So I work a lot on PMC, but also on Dynaudio, and.
Wow, they're two very, very different speakers.
Yeah, it's two very different studios. You know,
okay,
One is my own and the other one is a stamped studio. So.
Yeah.
Let's get to the next track.
One thing. I was surprised by the grunt of the organ, you know.
Minutes. It was nice.
Yeah.
Now, I'm a keyboard player, so it was as if, you know, you have your Leslie... Mm-hmm. Just one
in front,
in front, you know, but it wasn't
overkill.
It wasn't too much. It
wasn't exaggerated. No. Yeah.
It wasn't exaggerated, because it's very easy to to have the Leslie.
Yeah. Fire and Rain for you?
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
You're such a good DJ. Yeah.
Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you. Look down upon me, Jesus. You gotta help me make a stand. You just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Whoa, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. Whoa, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you, baby, one more time again now. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few things coming my way this time around.
That's a lovely wow. track, Rinus.
Oh man!
Yeah, goosebumps.
It's the openness and of this track, the cello.
Yeah.
It's the fills. Yeah. I'm really amazed how it sounds in this system.
Well, the chat really. Just exploded.
Yeah, really.
About how well this sounds.
It's my favorite singer-songwriter, of course.
Nearing the end, it gets a little bit rough for my taste. Yeah. I don't know what they did in the recording, but
that also gives emotion.
Yeah. And it does. It wasn't irritating me.
No.
It's a very beautiful track.
Yeah.
Do you know something more about recording?
No. Luckily not. It's not a very young recording.
No.
For that reason, I like it very much. Yeah, I think it's 25 years old. But it's a sample for me to check sound on the system. And I'm really amazed of the sound of this track on this system.
Yeah.
Really.
I thought the vocal was amazing.
Oh, yeah.
Really very clear.
It's really well done.
Grabs you by the throat. Really.
Yeah. Sounded very natural.
Yeah. Yeah.
Was floating nicely on top of the rest of the music, mostly.
Yeah.
That's one of the things that changes in the end. It kind of gets a little buried, but still it was very precise.
Yeah,
maybe because it's older, they didn't have the bandwidth or the technology to make the...
I don't know if it needed this, because it's amazing.
It's perfect.
It's what it is. The whole band coming in.
And also... What you said, the fills, they were like, wow, what's happening? It's like the rest of the recording, you can hear that it's kind of old technology indeed sometimes. Like you were talking about close miking for the first track. This is
close.
More, it's like right on the snare, you know.
But so well balanced.
Yeah, and then the toms, they pop out. And
the toms are.
Jesus.
You'll hear the difference. Sound, you know, the voicings of the toms, you can easily hear it.
But also nicely, like spaciousness around it, reverb or room. Yeah, beautiful.
Yeah.
And now for something completely different. It's one of my tracks I like. I like electronic music mostly. But honestly, I love this as well. And but something completely different. You know it. It's Emanuele Santoramana. opera, and it's a fusion of opera music with electronic music. It's tough on speakers, but I'm not in the middle, so you have to pay attention to the space in the track, because that's what it's all about.
And the volume.
Yeah, let's get it on. Ever heard the track like this. God.
And you know this track as well.
I know this track really, really well, but it's not even close to my reference system. Mm-hmm. I didn't hear any compression. Nothing.
Super precise.
Yeah. That's fingers in there.
Yeah, Jung knows that I can actually get tears in my eyes by this track. I don't know why, but it just grabs me. And I really love this. And It's all in the details and these effects around, and you know better how they create it, but I think it's a very nicely done fusion of opera music and electronics.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Wow, just wow. I yeah. How was the imaging?
Yeah, it was beautiful. The space around the strings was really nice. I do have to say that I still feel that I'm listening to speakers. Sometimes you can have that the speakers disappear.
Yeah.
Which is kind of what I learned from you, that to express it like that.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
I still feel like I listen to a pair of speakers.
Okay.
But the space was really, really special. But what struck me most was the precision. Just everything spot on.
Yeah.
Actually, my ears are starting to compress already.
Yeah.
Yeah, they're really sensitive. And this comes through so accurately that it's kind of like the rim shot is an attack to your ears.
Yeah, yeah, it is. Like, it is, it is.
Yeah.
Yeah. I think that's mighty impressive.
Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But it is... could be tiring, and one of the guys is asking, and you and Rinus can answer that better than I can. Do you guys feel the Dutch&Dutch are suitable for mixing duties, or are they more of a mastering speaker? Because it is different.
Mm-hmm. That's interesting. Yeah.
Oh, wrong camera. Sorry, guys.
Yeah, for mastering, it's a bit balancing. I believe more in balancing on the speakers than mastering.
Mm-hmm.
Do you agree?
Well, I think this is more your question for you. I'm not a mastering engineer.
No, I think I know them not well. I hear them also for the first time, but I think for the first impression is that it's more a balancing system than a mastering system.
So that raises the question: what are you looking for in a mastering speaker?
Wow.
Sorry.
That's a good question.
Honesty, I guess, always.
Yeah,
right?
more honesty, maybe. Yeah, yeah. Because this track is it became over me more than what you said. It's in the speakers and it doesn't come out.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So that's what I miss, and that's what I want to find on speakers. It's also mixing and balancing.
Mm-hmm.
You have to make it, but you also have the system that tells you you're on a good way.
Okay.
And maybe that's what I miss a bit on this system.
So it's more suitable maybe for the home, for people that are looking for a very honest speaker. They can adjust to their room because the capabilities of room correction are impressive in this one. And he set it to his taste. So there is a little bit of room gain.
Yeah.
You were there when he was measuring, so you know. And you can tweak that. So the bass the could be tweaked a little bit more neutral, I think so.
Yeah.
I like it this way, but I'm not a mastering engineer.
No. but what you guys were talking about the mid-range was, I think, audible on this track.
In
the mid-range there was I cannot explain it eloquently, but there was something in the mid-range that was not really, you know, of my taste, or it was too harsh or too much up front.
Yeah,
maybe that's why the
speaker
didn't...
Wow.
Maybe it showed the limitations of the...
That's the hard.
It was very loud.
Okay.
Yeah.
It was very loud.
Yeah.
All right.
But there was, so on this speaker, there was no DSP applied? Or
there is a DSP applied, definitely.
Maybe you should explain that, because that's...
Well,
this
speaker is actually a computer with units attached.
Yeah.
Yeah.
There's Linux running on this speaker right now. Yeah, no, I'm not kidding. It's really
it's
impressive.
Constantly, is it constantly measuring or is it?
Yeah, yeah. It's just a computer with some very decent amps and a unit.
It's
a really impressive what they did.
Wow.
Because you don't hear it.
Yeah.
It's only DSP.
Not a speaker, it's a computer.
Yeah.
It's a computer.
But that's actually, if you rephrase it like that, that's actually even more impressive, because I know of systems that have used DSP and they tend to start to sound fake.
Absolutely.
Right?
That's what I don't like about DSPs.
No. True.
And Grimm is sort of the same,
because
it's also DSP corrected. And I think they both did a great job, because you don't hear a computer playing.
No.
So, just to be sure, out of the DCS is analog or digital signal? What's coming out of DCS?
Analog.
Analog.
Yeah.
So, what it does reconvert it to digital?
Yeah.
Or
Yeah, wow. It's twice actually.
Yeah, it's twice.
Yes. It's going from digital to analog in the DCS. And then to from
the
analog to
DCS.
Actually, one more time.
Well,
because
the point is, we're going to compare apples to apples because the ATC is completely analog. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And you can feed it digital, and it doesn't need to convert twice mm-hmm, then. And mm-hmm. With Grimm, it's the same, but we have an ATC that is completely analog, and we have to run analog.
Smart.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we're going to switch some speakers now. This was the Dutch&Dutch. Let's get to the ATCs now.
I thought we were going to play Maroon.
Well, we're in 45 minutes already, so that's we're talking a lot.
We have so many viewers.
Yeah, but we broke all records already with the stream. So
we have to talk more.
It's going really well. I'm happy.
We have to talk more.
So for you guys, we're going to switch speakers. That's 5 minutes. Give us some time. I'm going to switch off audio, but you can see us. Heavy lifting.
Breaking our
back.
What are
stuff
we going
like
to do? What are
bank. En dan moet hij weer aan. Ja. Right. Let me know if the audio is on. Then I know that we are audible. ATCs are...
Right.
I hope there's a focal Sopra one as well. Okay, it's on. Good. No, we don't do the Sopra this time, guys. Sorry. You know, it's one of my favorite speakers, but this is only active studio stuff. Well, 70 kilos each. They are really heavy.
Power.
And completely different. We heard that on Friday already. But let me tell some stuff about this speaker. And then the experts can tell what they think. I can already tell you it's completely different than the Dutch&Dutch.
Yep.
ATC is all about the mid-range, isn't it? It's a dome mid-range, really special.
Yeah,
British.
And it's this one is completely analog. So it's a really active system. Each unit is powered by a whole lot of watts. 350 in each speaker, but it's different than the Dutch&Dutch in terms of amplification.
Mm. In what way?
The Dutch&Dutch has each speaker driven by, I think it's a Class D amp.
Mm-hmm.
And this is Class AB. So I noticed that it's just like diesel and gasoline. The horsepower is different.
Yeah, okay.
And Class D, I always have the feeling you need more of Class D than Class AB. Maybe I'm completely wrong and all the technical guys are like, what? It's the same. I have a feeling it's kind of different.
Mm-hmm.
It's a three-way ATC, and the crossovers are on 380 hertz and 3.5 kilohertz. And Ulm told me that a three-way ATC has a certain signature that you either like or don't.
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's find out. It's 13,000 euros around, excluding VAT. So that's around 15,000 euros, I think, per pair. So it's 2.5 more than the Dutch&Dutch, because I said it was 10, but it's 12.5.
Mm-hmm.
Maybe it's 10 excluding VAT.
The Dutch&Dutch is 2.5, 12.5.
12.5, yeah, 12,500 euros, including VAT. Yeah.
By the way, this is also like the living room edition? And it's
no, this is the pro version. The living room edition is even better finished.
Okay.
Maybe with the front.
There is something I have to tell you, by the way, that the Dutch&Dutch will be room connected, so you don't need anything.
Mm.
You don't need a preamp, you don't need a streamer. It's going to be fully room compatible.
Wow.
And this is just speakers with amps.
Active, yeah.
Yeah. So let's get started. Which track? I think Jacques Boucher. Let's try that one.
Thank you.
Now that's different.
Jesus Christ. Yeah.
Yeah.
Apples and pears.
Yeah. Apples and pears. Yes, definitely. Wow, this is really different.
Yeah.
I wonder, does the audience experience that right away as well?
Yeah, they all say it's completely different. Yeah. They do say, though, and you can hear that better than I can, but they do say it's more like you're in the room.
Yeah, absolutely.
Exactly. It's a bit of the difference between digital and analog.
Yeah, I think so.
Yeah, me too.
Yes,
yeah.
And I think I'm one of the oldest guys in this room, I think. It gives me a happy feeling.
We talked about when hooking it up, it sounds like the old good old JBL.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah, I'm a JBL freak.
I don't know the number, the 13 something.
4311.
43, yeah.
Yeah, I know them. Yeah.
Yeah, so they are right. It's more like you're in the room.
Yeah.
Immediately struck me, it's a little bit warmer.
Yeah.
And it has a lot of punch in the bass.
Yeah. The kick is more natural than the other system.
Yeah. Which is funny because I know ATC sometimes has the name in the dance industry of not having that low pressure that you need. Yeah.
A punch, yeah.
Compared to
PMC,
for instance, or vocal or something.
Yeah.
But I mean, no complaints here.
No. I'm like, what?
What was funny, though, I thought, was that you were talking about that tom on the in the right speaker. That actually stood out more on the Dutch&Dutch.
Okay.
It had more space to be fully boom.
Yeah.
You know,
it was more. You know, it was more analytic, more layered.
Layered.
This one was more. You know,
smooth.
Integrated.
Integrated. You can call it. They can give it different denominations, but you can also call it more muddy. It was more together, more, and the other one was, you know, layered. The tom was there.
You are absolutely right about the layering, because this is more like one coherent thing, and the Dutch&Dutch was more precise, and you could
separate it.
Yeah. But there you go again. It's
differentiated.
A computer.
Yeah.
Maybe.
Digital analog. Yeah.
Yeah. Maybe. Yeah.
That's really cool that we still have the Grimms, because then we can have more of an opinion on what we think about these differences here.
Yeah.
I'm really curious now.
Yeah.
Okay, onto the next track.
Yeah.
One guy said, limit to your love.
Nice.
Yeah, I think that's a good one. Let's check that one. Yeah.
Was it? A song?
Yeah, James Blake.
The original, by the way, is by Feist. She's amazing as well.
Oh, you could listen. Yeah, Feist in her voice.
Feist, yeah. Oh. That's but I want to have the James Blake.
Yeah, of course. That's why he's
going to be really fun.
I'm pretty sure.
That was a good one. Yeah. Let's try it. There we go.
There's a limit to your love. Like a waterfall in slow motion. Like a map with no ocean. There's a limit to your love. Your love, your love, your love. There's a limit to your care. So carelessly there. Is it truth or dare? There's a limit to your care. There's a limit to your love. Like a waterfall in slow motion. Like a map with no ocean. There's a limit to your love. Your love, your love, your love. There's a limit to your care. So carelessly there. can.
Yeah, I think so.
Wow. How are your ears, people?
Limit to your laugh. Limit to my eardrums,
yeah.
I guess. It's intense.
For me, that's way less intense than the last track of the last speaker.
Serious?
In the midst, yeah, absolutely.
Oh, wow. Okay. Nah, this for me is too much.
Everyone's different, I guess.
Yeah, probably.
It's intense, but I can...
handle it.
Yeah, I can handle this much easier.
In one way, yeah.
Well, so much about the low end of the ATCs.
Some say it's it's impressive, and it is. I think it goes linear to 20 hertz or something.
It sounds big overall.
Yeah,
it's not just big speakers, but it really does sound big. And the precision of, I mean, it's a totally crazy low part, of course, like but the precision in how the speaker
gives it to
us, it's amazing.
Yeah,
and especially like you said, no compression,
no,
the top stuff, like the rim shots and everything, it's effortlessly on top of this craziness in the lows.
That is impressive.
Yeah,
it is. Yeah, they did a great job.
The voice, I think the voice is sounds very
piano. Good.
And the space, the reverb around it.
Yeah, yeah. Well balanced. Yeah.
Yeah. Love it.
Let's get to some music. Actual music now.
Oh,
James Taylor.
This was impressive, but
James Taylor.
Yeah, let's do James Taylor. I like that track. So
same period as the speakers were originated.
Yeah, it's also a James.
Okay.
James Blake, and James Taylor.
Yeah.
James Bond.
Shoot you something in that.
Yeah, James Bond.
James Bond.
We still have that one.
James Bond. Yeah.
It's harder, right?
Yeah, it's harder.
Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. Walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. You just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. that I thought would never end. I seen lonely times when I could not find a friend, but I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's always the time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend, but I always thought that I'd see you, baby, one more time again. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few things coming my way this time around now. Thought I'd see.
Ja, ik kreeg bij het eerste systeem
English,
het idee van...
English.
Oh, sorry. I get the impression with the first system van, wow, but now, this is more natural than it is. This is more the recording as it is. Mm-hmm. Especially on the attacks, on the fills,
yeah.
and the cello. Yeah, this is more... This gives me more the impression that it's an original track.
Yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
I have a double feeling.
Me too. But I agree.
Yeah,
yeah. It's not that I think, wow, this is so much better. No, it's
no,
different.
No, it's different. Completely different.
And considering the fact that this is huge and it does some things absolutely better, especially with the
yes,
how do you call it?
On the
attack
fills.
On the fills.
On the fills. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah. The transients.
The transients. Yeah.
The vocal part, I'm not so sure.
Me, same here.
Oh. Yeah? Exactly. Okay. Yeah.
Yeah, the other one, I think Jung said it best when he said, like, it's more analytical.
Yeah.
And in some ways, that kind of helped this track for me.
Yeah.
To bring out the message of
it
the
vocal
more.
Repaired the flaws, maybe, of the recording. The flaws.
Yeah. What struck me, though, and it also struck me with the first track, I'm listening to instruments more, it seems.
Definitely.
Like the guitar is more a guitar here, as stupid as that may sound.
But I
think that's what you're referring to as well. Actually, I didn't say, because we skipped to the next one, but in the first track, I heard mistakes of the musicians. It's like, I didn't catch
this
that.
This first track?
No, the French guy?
Yeah.
Jacques Lusher. Yeah.
The drummer is missing one
exactly.
of the kick drums.
Yeah, you're right. I hear the drum.
Yeah.
Oh,
he missed
the kick.
Yeah. Yeah.
And a few piano notes that are wrong. Yeah. And I didn't catch that the first time, which is kind of the other way
around.
Because this is less analytical, but I heard it here.
Yeah.
Wow, that's so.
What struck me on this one were the cellos. They were so much richer than with the Dutch&Dutch. They were wider and they had more coloration.
Yeah,
and more, yeah, impressions. I don't know what they had more. They were richer in tonality, and also they became louder, on approximately 2/3 of the records, and it was less discernible at the Dutch&Dutch. Mm-hmm. But you know, you're right. It's all in the details, and it's nuances.
Yeah, but the funny thing is, it's a totally different speaker.
I was back in the 70s, you know, with his...
And still.
Yeah, exactly, yes.
Yeah, oh yeah.
James Taylor, this kind of music.
Yeah.
I'm curious when we would hook up a good record player and a good record, you know. I think you wouldn't leave. You just want to play a record. Yeah, please.
Well, coincidentally, we are in a vinyl presence.
Yes. Let's go downstairs.
Small hint, but I think, wow. What
can
a set.
I get to, let's pick Vultures?
Could you do the John Hopkins one? Like, totally different?
Or John Hopkins? Oh, yeah. Everything connected.
Yeah, it's... Yeah.
Let's do that. There we go. right.
Wow.
Nice ending.
No, sorry, beautiful fade out.
The DCS does a good job in fading out. Sorry about the brute ending of this song, but it's a 10-minute track. If you like it, it's everything connected by John Hopkins, John J-O-N. And there were some comments in the comment section, it exploded.
Yeah.
What kind of music is this?
You know, Mark.
Well, it was Mark.
Yes. And Mark, what do you think about the sound?
Super impressive. This is a track that is able to sound big on a lot of systems, but it can quickly get aggressive.
Yeah, I can imagine.
But the mids are so well. I know ATC mid dome tweeters are mid domes are amazing, and this proves that again.
Yeah.
With the power in the lows, with the sound stage, it's just huge. Yeah.
Even in this spot, and I'm not in the middle at all, it's still huge.
Yeah. Yeah.
And there were some comments about harshness. They said it for a dance track that can get harsh pretty fast.
Yeah.
It's still so smooth. Mm-hmm. It's not aggressive at all.
You have intelligent viewers.
Yes. Well, we have some good ears on the other side.
But Mark, what do you thought about the kick attack? Is it as it is, or do you? I miss it a little bit. Maybe I don't know if it is the speaker
or the recording.
A bit kick attack.
Well, I think, to be honest, I didn't really pay attention to that all that much. I was very much focused on the aggressiveness and the sound stage, but I can imagine. I've heard this on bigger systems, and then it really, really pushes through. However, thinking as a producer, the way to get things to sound overwhelming, and I think you know this as well, is also to kind of not have things stand out too much, to have total all these pads and all these effects to have them sounding at the forefront so you don't push the kick out too much.
I would say there's so much in this recording, so much layers that actually I thought it was intended by the master or mixing engineer to have these kicks, you know. And
The question is it the speaker or
is it not?
Well, I think it's a good remark. I think it might have been a little bit more separated.
A bit of the tech, you know.
So this was your Amsterdam dance event. This
Well, your own personal dance event then.
Yeah. By the way, for the people that were saying, what kind of music is this? John Hopkins is not just any guy.
No.
He's also behind Coldplay.
Oh, really?
Yeah, he's collaborated with them. London Grammar.
London Grammar, nice.
Yeah. Even Jin Heap.
Beautiful.
So he's in the business.
Yeah.
There is some requests for new viewers. I'm getting some comments about the windows. They're not windows. It's
optical illusions.
We have viewers that are very critical on the setup.
Yeah,
and
a good question.
That's very good, but we will never, ever put speakers in front of windows. That's LED panels. No glass, no
plastic.
Stuff like that.
It's
so
plastic.
No worries about that. let's try one more track. I think Vultures is the one, and then we can go to the Grimm, because then we'll start Vultures on the Grimm as well.
Maybe cool. That's
so we have a direct comparison between the ATCs and the Grimms.
Love it.
Let's do that, because man,
again.
Yeah, again. We always run late. I'm sorry. It's just...
It's passion.
It's too much fun.
We don't mind, you don't mind.
No.
Do you?
Let's get to John Mayer, Vultures.
Of us.
Okay.
Wow.
I want to say something to my viewers. It's just so cool. I only see positive stuff. It's, man. It really gets me emotional. Mm-hmm. I could cry.
How many people are there?
We have the all-time record, 163 online now, wow. And we had 2,000 viewers
already.
Already. So, give me goosebumps.
Good.
Thanks, guys.
Thanks to you, man.
Yeah.
Really touches me.
You're doing it, man.
Yeah, you're doing it.
It's great. No, you, we.
Yeah, we.
you set it up. Some credit for you.
It's been yes. hard work.
Kudos.
To get it to this point, and I'm so glad we can do this. Okay. Wow.
And we are, too.
Yeah. Once you get out of bed to give us music. Well, yeah. We do.
May I ask you, you're used to the PMCs in the back. Yeah. What's your hunch on
good question.
Differences, parallels? May we ask that question?
You don't want to know how long it takes that I make a decision to make the good choice of the speakers. Of course, there is a commercial thing, there's a marketing point, and of course, the sound is number one.
Yeah.
The PMC. The choice for the PMC is still made because I think it's a speaker where I can do balancing and mastering. Maybe there are better speakers for only mastering and only recording and balancing, but you have to do several things. I do everything on those speakers, so I think this is the best middle way of using speakers in the studio where you do.
Mm-hmm.
I do also the direct cuts, so you do. It's a multi speaker, and multi system.
It's a multi-tool.
It's a multi-tool. I think one of the best multi-tools to use, to be honest.
Okay.
And sound-wise, would you what we, because we cannot show you let you hear.
We already talk about GBL.
Yeah.
I'm a GBL fan. Yeah. I also like the Pro system of GBL. Yeah. It's amazing good, but it's a bit colored, and that's the only thing in low frequencies. And that's nice to hear, but difficult to work on.
Yes.
to work on it.
Well, coloration is interesting because Do you think there is color in here in the lows?
Yeah,
I think a bit.
Yeah,
I think so.
Yeah, I think so.
It's a bit gezellig, right?
Yeah. You can listen to this longer than on the first system. Somebody said, oh, I can listen the whole day to this kind of music. But on this system, you can still listen longer. This is so nice. This is really nice.
Yeah.
Yes.
And I think this track was significantly better on the ATC than the D&D.
Yeah, really. Yeah.
I think the D&D does not color as much as this. I think it's cleaner than this, but the ATC has some show.
Yeah.
Some show
in there. Gravy.
It's gravy.
Honest.
Yeah, yeah.
Not very colored.
No, I agree.
No,
it's not.
Yeah,
no,
it's all marginal.
Yeah.
That's very.
I mean, they're all top class.
Details.
That's a problem.
Yeah. But I think if you put the D&D next to the ATC.
You close your eyes, you take this choice, I think.
Yeah.
With this track, 100%.
Well, we were in Munich when it was, and we stumbled upon this one.
This is crazy. And
we couldn't get away. We don't have to go. We will stay.
That was a funny moment because we came from the neighbors, and it was a 300,000 euro system playing over there. It was crazy. And was like, it's really good.
Not bad.
It's not bad. I mean, I could live with this.
Can we have two?
Then we walked into the ATC room where it was just, I think it was 50K. I mean, it was a serious system playing
an amp
over there.
And two speakers, you know?
No, amp. It was active.
It was active.
It was a source with IKEA a power cords and stuff. It was but not set up at all, like next to the neighbors. And I was like, holy shit, this is really good. We couldn't get away.
That's the reason why you don't have
money. Doesn't matter.
Must go to that kind of stuff.
This is just so musical.
It is super musical.
Yeah, musically. Yeah.
Let's get the Grimms out there. I mean, concluding. Conclusion, ATC.
More natural.
Can they stay here and drag them to the other side of the hole?
Let's
where my studio is.
Yeah. You buy left, right, and left one. I buy right one. You share.
Yeah, no.
I think they're really.
I
good.
Think we said it all.
Yeah.
It's
just a really good system.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. Yeah. And
I think
really
for the money, it's extremely good. I mean, 13,000 euros. Yes, it's a shitload of money. But my vocals are 9,000 a pair.
Yeah, without.
And my amplification is 15,000.
Exactly.
So we're talking 24,000 euros, and honestly, this is better.
You know, in the good old days when you were playing music seriously, my bass player had tenors, you know, these big ones at home, student home. I think nowadays you should have, as a musician or a producer, you should have this one at home, at home, which will show you're the boss at home. So I'm the one who's making decisions on what system is at home. But this is really musicians. Thing,
yeah,
you know,
but
yeah, I work at the conservatory here in Haarlem as well, and we have several ATC systems, and it's all the students are also just blown away with the capabilities.
Mark, I guess we have to tell them you're Dutch because they said this is the first Dutch non-Dutch person who says gezellig the right way. You have a good accent.
Rebuild.
We're gonna switch. Place the Grimms. It takes 5 minutes, so you can grab a coffee and be back in five.
I'll get some coffee too.
Let's see. Yes, there we are. We're back.
Back to Holland.
Well, whoa. Okay. That's Down My Knees by Air. Hey, yo. Well, the Grimm LS1be. Our reader community knows what I think about this speaker. I think it's one of the best speakers I've ever heard for the price. There are better speakers, but you have to pay so much more. And that's, I think, the power of integration and active systems. I mean, the ATC is a bargain if you think about the quality, and the D&D as well. I mean, 12,500 euros for an active speaker with Rune, network connectivity and everything you want is just a very good deal.
Yeah.
The LS1BE is 36,000 euros. That's a lot of money. But we have a worldwide first, because this is the first LS1BE with the new adaptations. There's a new analog, there's a new sample rate converter in there that's a lot better than the previous one, and the subwoofer has been modified. So it's supposed to be even better than the previous subwoofer. And there's some stuff I need to tell about the subwoofer system. Maybe some guys in the chat know it already, but Grimm uses motional feedback in their subs. And that's actually a system that measures the movement of the woofer and compares it to the input. And if the input is A and the movement of the woofer is B, it can correct itself.
It's a feedback system.
Yeah. Feedback system.
It's a feedback system.
It's an invention by Philips, but it was an analog system and it was ridiculously expensive. So they didn't bring it to market because there was just no market.
No.
Because of the price. they made it in the digital domain. It's completely insane if you think about it. When I first heard this speaker, I had the feeling I was listening to room correction. It was so extremely tight. It's just ridiculous. There was no resonance in the room at all. So that was really impressive. And I don't think you hear a digital system, because just like the Dutch&Dutch, this is completely DSP controlled. And I don't like DSP systems, especially room correction systems. And my readers and viewers know what I think about an active room correction. I don't like it. So that's the LS1BE. There was one request about clapping. So I'll just, let's see if this is the right camera. I don't know for sure. Is that the right? No, that's not the right one. I have this one.
Okay, I'll check if it's on.
About the room. 100 milliseconds around?
Yeah, well.
So, yeah. Now you know. That's the acoustics. Okay. Let's play the first track, I think.
John Mayer. Right?
Yeah. John Mayer, Vultures. We just heard it on the ATCs, so now for something completely different. I already leveled it if it's all correct. There we go.
We're to kill before.
Doing with us?
Oh.
You're killing us.
Wow, well, I heard some new stuff.
Me too.
Yeah.
That, yeah. And yeah, you guys on the camera didn't see, but I was looking at Mark, because it's his test track, and I said, that guitar over there.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
It was so noticeable, mm-hmm, suddenly.
It was already noticeable on ATC.
Yeah, I know, but I wasn't paying attention.
It was there was more
now
detail.
It grabbed my attention.
Yeah, and the organ that came up, it's more detailed. I don't know what happened, but
yeah,
it's the best version I heard now.
This is how the snare should sound.
Yeah.
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 And the fatness,
I agree.
The fatness of it.
Yeah, it's insane.
I do have to say, on first listen, I told you when I walked in here when we were setting it up, it's like, hey, it doesn't impress me right away,
no,
but that's because of the tightness of the lows, I think.
Yeah, it's really
this happens
tight
a lot. Like ATCs, like we said, it's more muscly.
Yeah.
And but therefore a little bit less honest than what we're hearing now, and that takes some getting used to. I don't know if anyone would disagree, but
I agree, and that's their philosophy. Actually, you're describing now. That's funny that you say that, because I had exactly the same with the Mu1 streamer. Mm-hmm. Like, yeah, okay, and what's next? But then you take it away, and it's like, what the fuck?
Amazing.
It sounds so normal that it's not impressive, but you know how impressive it is as soon as you switch. That's the whole thing. Yeah, well, let's get to the next track, I think.
Yeah, also I wanted to say still, this is the system where you can least hear the speakers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's just, it's music over there.
Yeah,
it's gone.
Yeah.
And you did this. Yeah, I heard it on the same moment. I was like, wow, it's room filling now. And I think it's supposed to be like that.
Yeah. Yeah, well, if you listen to it on, I don't know, like a laptop or something, it doesn't. No, but I mean, it's kind of hidden, and here it just gets all the breathing space that it needs. Yeah.
Details.
Cool.
And the ugliness of the vocal as yes. well. Like, yeah.
Yeah. Wow. It's really sharp.
Yeah.
Well, it seems as he, when he starts, it's really, you know, what about your F and S's? And it gets better. So,
yeah.
He starts.
They made a mistake in the beginning, and the engineer thought, oh, moo.
Or that's not true, of course. Just, you know, I don't know, he had a beer, I don't know. No.
It's the mistake, and they leave it. It's
improving.
Ah, yeah. It could be. Yeah.
You never miss your water until your well runs dry. That's well said, Ronald. Yeah, it's true. Let's get to Fire and Rain.
Oh.
Yeah, let's do that. There we go.
Just yesterday morning, they let me know you were gone. Suzanne, the plans they made put an end to you. I walked out this morning and I wrote down this song. I just can't remember who to send it to. I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Won't you look down upon me, Jesus? You gotta help me make a stand. Just got to see me through another day. My body's aching and my time is at hand. I won't make it any other way. Whoa, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. Seen sunny days that I thought would never end. Seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you again. Been walking my mind to an easy time, my back turned towards the sun. Lord knows when the cold wind blows, it'll turn your head around. Well, there's hours of time on the telephone line to talk about things to come. Sweet dreams and flying machines in pieces on the ground. Oh, I've seen fire and I've seen rain. I've seen sunny days that I thought would never end. I've seen lonely times when I could not find a friend. But I always thought that I'd see you, baby, one more time again now. Thought I'd see you one more time again. There's just a few things coming my way this time around now.
Yeah.
God, this is impressive.
This is the voice of James Taylor.
Yeah?
Yes, this is almost like the original. I like this very much. This is very good. Again, so detailed. What I heard on the ATC, on the cello, that's for me an important part.
Yeah.
When he goes to the low frequencies, there's a bit rounding more than on the, this is flat.
It stays
tighter,
in control.
Straighter.
Also, you know, the fills of the drums.
Oh, yes, man. Open as
amazing.
It is
amazing open and yet sound pressure it's
oh still
amazing
it actually really touched me, the song. The vocals are so real.
What I also think is funny from a mixing perspective, I've always felt that this track kind of like it's amazing and obviously the people involved did an amazing thing, but the leveling of the vocals is kind of terrible. You hear almost like the guy using the fader and making mistakes.
Yeah.
And that is so apparent here as well.
Yeah.
And the thing is, that can actually contribute to the emotion because he's trying to push more emotion into the song, probably.
Probably, yeah.
But it's like relentless. It's unforgiving.
Yeah.
And what I especially liked indeed was the realism of the vocal, but also the body of the acoustic guitar on the
in
left.
The beginning, yes.
Jesus.
Yes.
That was like the guitarist is here, which is always what I'm looking for. Like, can I believe when I close my eyes that it's happening
in front of the speakers?
Yeah,
exactly.
It was jaw dropping.
Yes.
Yeah. He started playing like,
wow.
Yeah, the start. Yeah.
Yeah.
Amazing. Yeah.
Crazy good.
Yeah.
Jacques Lussier?
Jacques
Lussier. Oh, yeah. I'm curious about the bass now. That's the hard part.
Oh, wow.
Let's get it on. I have to admit, it was a little bit louder than previous. It was 4 dB, so I tuned it back a little bit in the middle. But God, well, it's a fast speaker.
the toms.
Yeah.
So deep.
It's insane.
This is the most realistic speaker I've ever heard.
Yeah,
it's just the same for me.
I already knew it when it was in your testing.
Oh, yeah, you were there.
Yeah, but that was the LS1A.
Okay.
It's a cheaper brother.
Without the sub, right?
It was with the
sub.
With sub. But the normal sub, and even that is crazy good.
Yeah.
This is just a whole other level.
Yeah.
And it like you said, it's the most honest speaker I ever heard.
Yeah, so good.
Yeah.
It kind of reminds me, funnily enough, of when you're listening to a sound card in the studio and then switch to Kees Ruitenberg's new Sonnet audio.
Yeah.
It has the same kind of experience in terms of added spaciousness for me.
Yeah.
Mm, yeah.
Yeah, it's true.
And detail.
Detailed, yeah.
And it doesn't sound digital at all. You don't hear anything in...
No.
No. That's the best strength.
Digital system who give us an analog bend in front of us.
Yeah, but that was with the interview with Grimm as well. Digital doesn't have to sound digital as long as you do it right. And it's the same with the DSPs and the Dutch&Dutch speaker. They do it right, so you don't hear a computer.
Yeah, no.
And all the people say digital and CD and streaming sounds harsh. No. It doesn't need to be harsh or... anything. I think this proves the whole point.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I don't
We have three good systems. Let me talk about
They're all three crazy good.
Price wise, there is something to tell about.
Well, yeah.
But what about the difference?
You pay a premium for this one.
There is the one you tested at the LSA or so?
There's the LS1 A, that's the entry level speaker. It's around 10,000, I think it's around the Dutch&Dutch level.
And how would it compare to the...
Well, I think it's really different. I think for me, I was spoiled because I heard this one first. It's the same with the DALI Apicon, and then you go to the Rubicon. You know how the Apicon sounds, so the Rubicon is not as good. Mm. It obviously not as good. And I thought the LS1A wasn't as impressive as this.
No, I heard it at your place.
Yeah, this is just so crazy good.
Of course, yeah.
But my expectations were there.
Exactly, yeah.
So like, now it's going to happen. And it's like, it's not going to happen. You need to pay for a lot more for this to happen. So that's my opinion. I think this is crazy good. The LS1A, I don't know. They're very... It's going to be a hard battle between the Dutch&Dutch and the Grimm.
Yeah,
I think the Dutch&Dutch is really comparable, maybe even better.
On the pro level, I think this is also a system where you can do balancing, mastering, mixing. I'm sure about it.
For dance producers, it's probably not the best for electronic, because you want to have that weight in the lows.
I understand what you mean. Yeah.
That would be the ATCs. Absolutely.
Absolutely. Yeah. No, this is not for dance music.
No.
But speaking of dance music, can I play my opera song?
Of course.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm really curious. I've never heard it on this speaker.
Okay.
Let's go.
Don't cry. Thank you.
were silent, baffled.
Yeah, you you can't keep on listening on this system because this everything is so detailed and through and
you hear every freaking so nuance in the voice. That when she goes up and the long note,
On you hear things.
Everything.
Mm-hmm.
And I've never, ever, ever heard a system do it like this.
Mm-hmm.
It's just insane.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And we've heard some stuff, didn't we, Jung?
Yeah.
You've heard it this song a thousand
times.
The
detail, well, it's just astonishing, really. And the
truthfulness.
Yeah, we're actually.
Yeah, yeah.
We feel
like
quiet.
The energy has gone
yeah.
like that in the room.
But
right?
You know what strikes me, and I know I know I wrote that in my first review. It actually feels like the music is slowed down.
Mm.
It's like the song has been tuned back 10% because you hear everything. Your brain doesn't have to process that hard.
Mm.
It feels like the music is going slower, and I had the feeling exactly like now with this song, and I get goosebumps again.
Yeah.
It's just crazy.
Well,
how
it's the same as you go to a concert, whether it's classical or whatever pop. It's energy that you have to absorb. So you're kind of, tired. You're just sitting there with your beer, or you're driving home, and it's just no words.
Yeah.
And it's kind of the same feeling, We were not, I was not inclined to say something.
No.
I was
just listening.
Yeah.
It's impressive.
Same
enough.
Here.
Yeah.
Well, we all agree.
And
it's insane.
It's boring.
I'm wondering.
Yeah, it's boring.
No doubt about it.
Maybe we had some useful comments from the control room. Jaap is full of emotions. Yeah.
Yeah, I am actually really touched. If this song is played well, it grabs me.
I understand.
I really love this song.
Yeah.
I can't help it.
So
it was the same with Fire and Rain. It grabbed me. Like, wow, this is really nice.
It came out.
Yeah.
This is the way to play the music.
Let's do one more track. And then we do one request.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yeah.
And Jung is trying to get the attention of Martijn, I guess.
He had some useful feedback from the control room.
Yeah, he had some feedback.
I don't know if he wants to talk back from the top back.
Okay, so guys, we're gonna do one more track, and then one request because it's
maybe a request.
12.
A request now.
Just a request.
Yeah. I don't know the request.
Marcus Miller, Detroit.
Okay. Why not?
Trade in the Tesla for the Grimms. That's a good one.
I know a buyer for the Tesla.
Yeah, Mark wants the Tesla, I guess. Survivor, Popular Girl, Michael Landau, Can't Buy My Way Home. That's a nice one. All about the detail. Dead Can Dance.
Yeah. Ooh,
oh,
that's pretty.
Yeah, it's good.
Yeah.
Which one?
It's from the 80s already,
it's
I think.
Yeah, but it's very...
The singer has also done the vocals for Hans Zimmer's soundtrack of Gladiator.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So I think we agree on Dead Can Dance.
Okay.
Dead Can Dance.
But yeah, it depends on what
song.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Okay, what song by Dead Can Dance? Oh, Aafje de Visser. Yeah, I'm sorry, I don't like that.
Really?
No, I don't like her.
Oh, okay.
No, There are two things I really dislike, and that's big band jazz. Yeah, I hate big band jazz.
You kidding?
Yeah,
really?
Really, I did.
Man.
It gets me nervous.
I played it in the studio just for illustration, and Jaap, I don't know what.
Oh, Dire Straits.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, man. Oh,
with
that's
your latest trick.
I haven't played that for 10 years.
Your latest trick.
Your latest trick by Dire Straits, yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Yeah, that's
Michael Brecker on saxophone.
Yeah, Dire Straits. My wife was complaining about Dire Straits because I've been to concerts twice, three times. She said, "Why don't you ever play Dire
music.
Straits again?" Yeah, sorry. your latest trick. That's on Brothers in Arms, isn't it? Yeah. Okay, there we go. Thank you.
orchestra between the satin bulls and their bells. Prehistoric garbage trucks have the city to themselves. Echoes and roars, dinosaurs, they all doing a monster mash. Most of the taxis, most of the whore, are only taking calls for cash. I don't know how it happened, it all took place so quick. But all I can do is hand it to you and your latest trick. Were laid back and laughed. It was only my heart that got it broken. You must have had a fast key made out.
Hele lange track.
Mm-hmm. Nog één?
Yeah, I'm gonna do Dead Can Dance. One track, and then we're gonna end this session. Conclude it. It's long enough. Been 2.5 hours already.
Mm-hmm. If they have to go for lunch.
So, yeah, it's lunchtime.
Restaurant.
There we go.
I think the Dire Straits track.
Yeah.
You can hear that on the voice that it's really natural and as it is. It's I never heard Mark Knopfler.
No.
This for no. On the speaker system.
Me neither. I've never heard it so clean.
No, exactly.
It was funny though. I was checking, like, has the mix engineer tried to mix his voice in stereo? Because it's not in your face.
No.
No.
And it kind of makes sense because Mark Knopfler, of course, isn't much of a singer.
No, he's not
he's really
singer.
A storyteller,
yeah,
right?
Exactly. Yeah.
So it felt to me like the mix engineer made the conscious decision to kind of not put it like in straight front. In the middle in yeah. front. Yeah.
Yes, but a part of the.
But that's how so much how easy it is to trust the system.
Yeah.
I didn't know this track that well.
No.
But yeah, I immediately felt like, okay, that's how it must have been done.
Must, yeah.
Yeah,
not like the system must portray it in the wrong way. No, that's what the
that's
mix
way.
So you actually heard what they did?
Yeah.
I mean, I could, from just listening to a few songs, I could already trust that the system will give me honest.
Yeah.
Well, you can hear so much transparency. You know, this was the one of the first CDs released in the CD era. So
you
hear it everywhere.
It was an early recording.
Yeah.
I want my MTV. And it was all these, you know, the very close mics. But here I could hear it actually. The Dire Straits, well, it is a good band, but there were flaws in the drum and bass.
Oh, yeah.
Synchronicity. Mm-hmm. I never heard that, but it wasn't. So it was very, you could hear so much detail.
Yep.
Yeah.
Shall we try to go from the D&D strong points to the ATC strong points to the LS1 strong points? Just as a conclusion?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I think the D&D is a very good deal for 12,500 euros, considering the fact you have everything in one speaker.
Yeah.
And it sounds very natural.
You just need the speakers.
Yeah, that's it.
Power and the internet cable.
That's it. You don't need anything else.
And it could, for a lot of people in the studio, actually, I think it could be a very good tool.
Yeah. Yeah.
Because of the amount of detail.
And price-wise, it's okay.
Yeah.
That's what.
You know, 30 is really.
This is really high-end.
But worthwhile.
Worthwhile, yeah.
That we get to that.
Yeah. So that's my opinion on the D&D. I thought when they were standing there, I was like, ooh. It's kind of small compared to the other ones, but they don't sound small.
Mm-hmm. No, certainly not.
No.
Very energetic.
Very
well.
Complete, punchy,
yeah.
Natural. Could you use it in your studio?
Yeah, definitely.
And you?
Oh,
yes,
sure.
Yeah,
too.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. That's six.
Yeah.
Give us a good price.
Yeah, that's...
No, it really is, especially because it's so versatile, I think.
ATC, big
fun,
big sound,
yeah,
a lot of fun.
Yeah,
I don't think it's the most natural speaker,
no.
But we're talking marginal differences.
Yeah, sure.
Because they're still very, very good and very revealing.
Yeah, but I think difficult to work on it.
Could be, yeah.
For different styles.
Yes, yeah.
I think actually I would probably. Coming from the electronic music, I would probably pick that one.
I understand.
The ATCs from actually even over the Grimms, not because they're more accurate, because they are the best overall, but they were the most pleasant still to listen to for me.
Yeah.
And it has to do with that I'm used to that kind of a low end as well. It's your ears can only hear the total thing at once, of course. And I'm thinking about how this was when we started listening to the Grimms. It was overwhelming in detail for me as well.
Yeah.
And that's also something to take into account when you're working. You could lose yourself in detail.
Oh yeah, yeah.
And I especially like the mid as well.
Yeah.
The mid is magical. Yeah, it's really good.
Magical mid.
I could use the ATC at home. Mm-hmm. Smaller brother, this is freaking huge, but
I would choose the ATCs in the studio and the Grimms at home.
For me as well. Yeah, definitely. Yeah, okay. Yeah, well, we agree.
Let's check.
No,
I have to save some money.
No car.
So, but we agree the ATC is a very pleasant speaker.
Oh, sure.
And it's a good tool.
Pleasant is a very good word, I think.
Yeah.
Then the Grimm. I'm touched again.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's
in its own league.
I think it's in its own league. Yes, yeah. I think there are no other speakers
at
that are so
I cannot find
so accurate and still so nice to listen to.
Yeah.
Well, I've listened for a while to the, of course, the Head Tower one.
Yeah, the Head Tower one.
Mains.
Yeah.
You know the big
Head
HEDD from the headphones and the smaller monitors they have. They have set up with a subwoofer, four drivers, actively powered and then a mid thing and then on top of it again. So you have a Dapolito system.
Yeah.
So it's huge. It's about 240, 220.
Yeah.
And very. And it's impressively in also neutrality and
power.
Yeah.
You would think that you will be blown away by the power, but you're not because it's
so controlled.
It's like a Ferrari driving 60.
So you're mentioning this now because
it has some similarities to the sounds, to the clarity and the presence and whatever sound stage of this one, because it's price wise it's more or less the same.
Mm-hmm.
Also 30,000. But you should compare it A to B, and the nice thing about this one is that the form factor is the head is huge.
Mm-hmm.
It's 240.
Yeah.
It's big.
Yeah,
it's
they're
heavy.
Really big.
Yeah. And this one, you know, it's.
You could even use it at home.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think
so let's end this stream. I think we all want some lunch.
Yep.
And our viewers as well. Well, I say thank you all for watching. It's been a long stream, 2.5 hours, but we had a lot of fun. And I thank you, Rinus, Mark, and Jung for doing this today with me.
It was
thanks for inviting.
And
and back in the control room.
And Martijn, behind the scenes. So, guys on the chat, thank Martijn as well, because he did all the mixing and mastering for this stream.
And what did
he
say?
A shitload of microphones to get this working.
And
so Martijn needs some
can
applause
you
as well. Okay, thank you all, and I'm gonna end the stream now.
Okay.
Bye bye.
Bye.